He's a smarter player than that. He knows he has 1-2 seconds before the defense gets back.
And Frankie Allen is going to use his use it or lose it timeout here with 3:32 to go before the half. And the margin at 6 points.
Well, JB, we saw a similar play like this yesterday when we were at Cal and Fresno State. It looked like it's just that time of year. You played a few non-conference games. You have finals that you're dealing with. And with Oregon State, I mean, it's looking very similar that, you know, the guys are just trying to find their rhythm right now, struggling to get it going. But sometimes you need this kind of first half to get it out the way, and you find your stride and you get it going.
As we take you inside the Oregon State huddle, what adjustment would you make here in the final 3:30?
Well, they were finding success going down to the paint. I think that's a good game plan. Now, Eastern Shore was able to get a few block shots, and it's like Oregon State started going away from it, but you can't shy away from it. That's where you have your advantage. Stick with it. It works for you. You have to commit to it, and we talked about that, the discipline that it takes to follow a game plan all the way through. You can't be knocked off your course just because the opponent found a little success against you.
That high-low action that Oregon State started with so successfully, has Maryland Eastern Shore necessarily taken that away, or has Oregon State gone away from it?
Well, Oregon State's gone away from it more than anything, because we just saw Roberto Nelson there in a high post making a play. So maybe you just have to give it different looks, but still stick with that strategy.
They are going to count the basket. Hakeem Baxter will have a free throw on the other side of this break and a chance for another 3-point play. You can bring it back to a one possession game.
You guys know what this is like. Dr. Neuheisel, can you please explain?
I'm going with the Trojans.
His offense is just going berserk. You're killing me, Matt. You really are.
We're talking ball here.
Football Weekly, Wednesdays at 6 on Pac-12 Networks.
We always knew that when we had another baby, we would love it if I could stay home. The kids shape what we do. Everything's about them. So we had to make a lot of changes. Quick Balance is this really nice feature of the Bank of the West app. The more I check into my balance, the easier it is for me to stay on track. You don't even have to log in.
Hold on tight.
You're on call, you know, 24/7. Every minute that the app saves me is a minute that I can spend with my family. And that means everything to me.
Yeah, I'm married. Does it matter? You do that for me? Really? Yeah, I'd like that.
Who are you talking to?
It's Jake from State Farm. Sounds like a really good deal.
Jake from State Farm at 3 in the morning? Who is this?
It's Jake from State Farm.
What are you wearing, Jake from State Farm?
Khakis.
She sounds hideous.
Well, she's a guy, so...
Another reason more people stay with State Farm. Get to a better state. At Jeep, we're giving you everything you need this holiday with Jeep Grand Cherokee, Jeep Wrangler, and an all-new Jeep Cherokee. And that means you can give a little something back. Come get some of the best deals of the year at the Jeep Big Finish event. Well-qualified current lessees of competitive vehicles can lease the 2014 Grand Cherokee Laredo 4x4 for $299 a month.
Tuesday is Hoops Night on Pac-12 Networks. The number 15 Oregon Ducks take on UC Irvine in a primetime showdown.
The Leafs with nobody covering on the backside.
Live coverage starts Tuesday at 7:30 on Pac-12 Networks.
Back in Corvallis, the Hawks on a little 12-5 run over the last 6 minutes to close the gap on the Beavs, and they'll have a free throw as we resume play. Roberto Nelson held to just 4 points in this first half so far. He is the nation's second leading scorer at 25.5 per contest. Oregon State. Baxter with the free throw.
I'm sorry, JB. Oregon State, you know, they've been pretty sloppy with the basketball. Already 6 turnovers in their last game against Arkansas. Pine Bluff, they had 19 turnovers in. And you shouldn't have that margin of turnovers. 9 assists in this game against Arkansas. Pine Bluff, only 20. So you're pretty much even there. You're playing against a team that's not even pressuring you like that. Just a lack of detail with taking care of the basketball.
Not an insignificant foul here on Francis Ezra. He'll pick up his second with 3:11 to go. And it's also a free throw opportunity for Angus Brandt.
Very significant. Ezra's been a presence in the paint on the offensive and defensive end.
Brandt earns a second, and it appears that Frankie Allen is going to let his big play through some moderate foul trouble, but if they can tack a third on the Hawks center, it could change the dynamic of this second half.
You fully expect Oregon State to go right at them.
3:11 to game time. We will send you to Mike Yam in our San Francisco studio for the State Farm halftime report. Apparently, Syracuse was taken to the limits. And also, the latest on the Pac-12 volleyball endeavors in the NCAA tournaments. State Farm halftime report, 3 minutes from now. Smith to Hakeem Baxter, and now back to Smith for third for three.
Dribble penetration. It causes defensive rotations, and it gives open shots.
Malcolm DeVivier and the Bees only up two now. Jarmal Reed in the backcourt with him. Here's Nelson. Can't leave him alone. That's just too easy a shot, and the Hawks are fortunate he didn't make him pay.
Looks like the Hawks are getting the basketball back. I thought that one was out on the Hawks, but here we were talking about them going to the halftime break just with a 10-point deficit, and now they have the chance to score or take the lead.
Meanwhile, Roberto Nelson starts 1 of 6 from the floor tonight. Has just 4 points.
Even Devon Collier with only 5. But just like we just mentioned with Hakeem Baxter for Maryland Eastern Shore, the scorers will get it going. It's just a matter of when.
Ishak Pitt feeds Baxter. Angus Brandt got a piece of it. And then the second chance blocked as well. Angus Brandt with 2 blocks on that possession. 14 left to shoot.
That's what makes him special defensively, is his willingness to take a charge one play and then his ability to go up and get a shot blocked the next play.
Short clock now, only 8 left. Smith sees it, off to Baxter. This for the tie. Too strong. DeVivier throws it ahead to Collier. Good run to the rim by the big, but he lost control of it. Turnover number 7 for the Bees.
You know, with most bigs, I would say maybe you don't throw them the basketball in that situation, but Devon Collier is more like a wing player. We've seen him get a rebound, go coast to coast, so you fully expect him to catch that basketball. But again, that lack of attention to details, making the catch before the finish, defending and rotating. Oregon State just not there right now.
Both teams shooting sub 40% as we close out this first half. Right in the eye of Nelson, it's Isaac Smith the third.
Oh, and Smith had some words for Roberto Nelson. Now, we saw a game here last year, a Pac-12 game against Utah. And I don't know if you remember, Jared Dubois started chirping at Roberto Nelson. Roberto ended up having a big half, almost 20 points in the second half. So let's see if that's what it takes to wake him up.
See the scoring run there for UMES. They have their first advantage of this contest just over a minute to go.
Here's the problem you run into if you're Oregon State. The Hawks are confident.
Ooh, is he feeling it or
he
what?
Yes, I'm telling you, they're confident. They're believing right now.
Nelson, you're right. He wanted the answer. He took that one right at the rim. It curled off, and it's pulled down by Pitt. Ishak Pitt leads a break. Baxter erased at the glass. And now it's Nelson on the runouts. He'll cruise in for 2. No. 2 free throws instead.
Well, you're right, JB. That play prior on the missed layup, Roberto had it in his eye that he wanted to score on this one. Just another smart play. He wanted to get the and one. It started with the block. Devon Collier is one of the rim protectors before Eric Moreland gets back. But at least for this run out for Roberto, and he tried to get the body. Usually finishes that play, but getting off to a slow start.
Could have dropped it behind his back there to Collier, trailing the play. Could have had the block and the dunk.
He wanted it, though. He wanted to get back at Smith.
Ties up the game with the first of 2 free throws. Devon Walker into the contest for Maryland Eastern Shore. Lamar already knew this, but they're from Princess and Maryland. The maroon and gray are one of your favorite vacation spots. Nelson got both. He has 6.
Now it's one of those places I'm going to have to visit.
Reminder that the State Farm Halftime Report is upcoming. Mike Yam will take you through the day in college basketball and an update on the volleyball pursuits in the NCAA tournament as well. Giveaway there by Smith. The 7th turnover for the Hawks, and Collier finishes in transition.
The Beavers electing to go back to the 1-3-1. They knew that this would cause problems for the Hawks. So this is something they can always fall back on just to change the pace, throw a little wrinkle into the opponent's momentum.
Baxter to the floor. Nelson follows him there, and he's going to get the personal foul. That'll be the first on Roberto.
Well, I know the crowd doesn't like it, but that's actually the right call. And I actually wish referees would make that call more often. You see players fall over the top of a player and reach around. And you see, for Roberto, he just slipped, but nevertheless, he falls on the player. And that's going to be a foul.
And he'll leave to be sure he doesn't get a second in these final 7 seconds. David Hall made the call. He's with Kevin Brill and Randy Hyreman tonight, our officiating crew. So the Hawks ever briefly had that quick lead. Now they trail by three. Of course, the shot clock turned off. The final shot there is if they want it.
Well, if I'm the Hawks, I'm attacking here. I'm trying to push, get to the basket.
That is not the one you wanted to give, because now they're in the bonus and they're going to get a 1-1 with 4.2 remaining. Well, we mentioned this story off the top that Roberto Nelson and Devon Collier are the top scoring tandem in the nation. And Nelson will be back in for offensive purposes here after being subbed out to avoid taking his second personal foul.
Well, plain and simple, Roberto and Devon have gotten off to a very slow start, not shooting the ball well, not making really good decisions. And I expect them to go into the halftime break, talk about some different ways to get these guys some good looks. We saw a few times Collier caught the ball in the paint, got a shot blocked. So now maybe you come out of the break and you use your pump fake a little bit since they're jumping at everything. You just have to make adjustments. That's part of basketball.
Jones brings it back to a one-point game. We'll see what the Beavs do with the final 4 seconds. Roberto Nelson took a look up at the clock, got the shot off, and disappointed in himself to not hit that deep three on the way to the locker room.
Well, it looked good, and it would have been a great jump start to what he needs going into the second half. But the two stars not shining quite yet. Go in the locker room, take a break, take a breather, figure out some other ways to get some looks. Come out in the second half, play a different game.
Combined 4 of 14 from the floor. They have a 34-33 lead on Maryland Eastern Shore here at Gill Coliseum. We'll step aside here and send you to our San Francisco studios. Check in with Mike Yam. The State Farm Halftime Report is coming up.
Appreciate it, man. I'm a big fan.
Me too.
This one goes out to a couple friends of mine.
When cold refreshment calls, Coors Light answers. Frost Brewed Coors Light, the world's most refreshing beer.
Jackson tries to pop it outside, breaks the tackle. He's at the 10 to the 5, and in! Touchdown, Beavers! Steven Jackson!
46 touchdowns, 3,625 yards. In 3 years at Oregon State, Steven Jackson played every down at a relentless and fierce pace.
Jackson bounces it outside, and he's going in again.
Jackson earned Oregon State's all-time rushing title, and his bruising physical play became an inspiration for future running backs. Today's sophomore running back Storm Woods looks to carve out his own spot in Oregon State history. In his first active season, Woods amassed an impressive 940 yards and 13 touchdowns, scoring three of them in a single game against Utah.
Touchdown, Beavers!
With Woods returning for the 2013 season, Oregon State is poised to make a run for the Pac-12 North title. Pac-12 Networks. Legends are made here.
You hear that? That's the sound of car insurance companies these days. Here a cheap, there a cheap, everywhere a cheap. You get it. So what if instead of just a cheap choice, you could make a smart choice? Like Esurance, for example. They were born online and built to save people money from the beginning. That's what they've always done. Not just something they cheap about. That's insurance for the modern world. Esurance, now backed by Allstate. Click or call.
Welcome inside our San Francisco studio to the State Farm Halftime Report. I'm Mike Yam. Beavers right now with a one-point advantage, as Lamar Hurd had indicated right before we got to the halftime. It's Roberto Nelson and Devon Collier struggling in this first half, but still have a one-point advantage. A silver lining for Craig Robinson's team. All right, number two team in the land, Syracuse, matching up against St. John's, Madison Square Garden. First half, Orange up 10. Oh, Jeremy Grant, that just filthy. Off the bench, the sophomore at 14-7. Final seconds right before halftime. Johnny's down by 14. Check it, make it 12. Rasheed Jordan's got the finish for Steve Lavin, the former UCLA head coach. Take you to the second half. St. John's down by 10, trying to make this run. Jakar Sampson by himself. He had 12-6. St. John's cuts it to a 6-point deficit. T'Angelo Harrison, he is the star for Lav. 21 points to lead the team. He had 7 boards. Later, we're tied at 60. Tyler Ennis, how about that move? Right in the paint. Finished with 21. The Boeheim's team up 2. They're leading by 7 here. That is just one of the nastier dunks you are going to see in college basketball. Grant, he's not having any of that. St. John's able to hold on for a win. LaSalle and Villanova. Here's Jay Wright. First half here, Javon Pinkston. 7 lead changes in the first half. Wildcats up by 2, but Nova able to really put the clamps down as this game just wore on. Chris Jenkins got the straightaway triple. Wildcats up 7. They shot 49% from the floor in this game. Later, LaSalle trying to hang around here. Terrell Wright has got the flush. 18 of his 20 came in the first half of play. Second half, Villanova up by 15. Jenkins in the corner by himself. He had 11 points off the bench. They just continue to roll. The Explorers are just having some problems. The Wildcats, just for good measure, you know, we preach patience and move the ball. When all 5 guys touch, that's usually a good thing. Wildcats, an easy win. State Farm gets to a better state. Well, we showed you the number 2 team in the land, the top-ranked team in the country. That would be Arizona. And on Saturday morning, went to Ann Arbor, got it done against Michigan. Nick Johnson made 6 free throws in the final 25 seconds. Sean Miller's team trailed by as many as 11. Called it a quality win for his team, and I would echo those same sentiments. All right, let's not forget, we got some pretty good games coming up here on the Pac-12 networks. Oregon also undefeated. They play on Tuesday. Dana Altman's team trying to rally. We will see a couple returnees, a couple guys. And Carter will be back in the lineup, as well as Dominic Hardis. But let's not forget, coming up just a bit, Washington State and USC also in action on the Pac-12 networks. Final Four was on the line. We'll check in on some women's volleyball action. We'll tell you who's going to be able to advance.
We don't have an alarm clock at all. The kids are the alarm clock. We have 4 boys.
He wanted 5.
Busy might be an understatement.
Between the kids, work, we have to stay on top of our finances.
We put away for college, retirement.
There's always something you can spend money on, but you really have to pace yourself. The Bank of the West app with Quick Balance is amazing for that.
I don't see us slowing down anytime soon. And with the Bank of the West app, we don't have to.
Beaver Nation is great. No matter where you go, we always have a good following of fans. Playing at home in front of Beaver Nation at Goss Stadium is unlike anything I've ever been a part of. The fans are loud. They know the game. Goss Stadium is built, so they're all really close, and you just feel like they're on your side, and they're always helping you. Coach Casey is a very intense guy. That's probably the perfect word for him. He loves winning, hates losing. His record shows that he's a competitor. And he teaches you a lot about how to play the game, how to be a man, and how to win. Some advice I'd give to an aspiring athlete, a little leaguer, always be working. There's always something you can improve upon. Your swing's never perfect, and your defense is never perfect either. So you just always got to be working, always improving yourself, always be hungry. I'm Michael Conforto. I play baseball for Oregon State. I play left field. Go Beavs.
I believe in Oregon State. I believe in her traditions. A heritage from the deeds and dreams of yesterday. I believe in her sportsmanship and honor, a reality with the students of today. I believe in her aspirations and her ideals. The assurance of a magnificent tomorrow.
The Pac-12 Halftime Report is brought to you by Quicken Loans for a mortgage experience that's engineered to amaze.
Mike Hammond in our San Francisco studios earlier today here on the Pac-12 Networks. You watched Arizona matchup against Texas Tech. Second half, Wildcats up by six. LaBrittany Jones by herself. Give her the easy two. 12 points, 15 rebounds. Wildcats trying to hold on here. Later, they're up by four. Amber Battle finishing on the other end. Give her the 2 points. Battle had 12 red. Raiders trying to fight back, trailing by just two. The Wildcats up by seven here. Jones with the rebound. Kenneth Wortham got the finish for Nia Butts' team. She had 23. It's the second win of the year for the Wildcats. USC and Washington. A trip to the Final Four when the volleyball on the line here. USC leading 1-0 second set and set point for the Trojans. Ebony Onwuegbu has got the kill. 30 kills in the match for her. USC leads 2-0. Third set. Huskies trying to fight back with set point. Kylie Nelson. 14 kills for her. The Huskies, they're able to take that third set. Now tied at two in the fifth. USC, it's match point. Pac-12 Player of the Year, Krista Van Zandt, comes up with a clutch kill. A career-high 38 for her. The Huskies still alive. Still in the fifth set, your senior reserve, Gabby Parker. It's your game-winning kill. Washington able to come back from two sets down to win 3-2 and advance to the Final Four. What a match that was. All right, Oregon State on top by one. As we told you, Devon Collier just 3-7 from the floor. 7 points. Roberto Nelson just 1-8. But right now, the Beavs still up by one.
You hear that? That's the sound of car insurance companies these days. Here a cheap, there a cheap, everywhere a cheap. You get it. So what if instead of just a cheap choice, you could make a smart choice? Like Esurance, for example. They were born online and built to save people money from the beginning. That's what they've always done. Not just something they cheap about. That's insurance for the modern world. Esurance, now backed by Allstate. Click or call.
Here's to being one of one, a true one of a kind.
So you can have a getaway from what you know. So you can be surprised by what you don't. Get 2 times the points on travel and dining at restaurants from Chase Sapphire Preferred. So you can taste something that wakes up your soul. Chase Sapphire Preferred. So you can.
At Jeep, we're giving you everything you need this holiday with Jeep Grand Cherokee, Jeep Wrangler, and an all-new Jeep Cherokee. And that means you can give a little something back. Come get some of the best deals of the year at the Jeep Big Finish event. Well-qualified current lessees of competitive vehicles can lease the 2014 Grand Cherokee Laredo 4x4 for $299 a month.
State Farm Halftime Report continues from Corvallis, where most of the snow from last week's storm has thawed out. BU's trying to thaw out their offense with a one-point lead over the Hawks at the half. It started promisingly enough, Lamar.
It did. It looked like Oregon State was going to dominate this game in the paint. They got it where they needed it to go. They finished plays. The execution was good. They ended up starting off inside, then moving it to the outside. Roberto Nelson knocked down a three. Olaf Schaftenaar knocked down a couple. The defense was clicking as well, which is typically Oregon State's point where they struggle on a defensive end on the floor. But then all of a sudden, the Hawks begin to fly. The three-point shots are going in. They got a confidence. They got extra pep in their step. Now you're looking at a one-point deficit for the Hawks.
Yeah, that was 6 3-point field goals by Maryland Eastern Shore, helping them rally to take that momentary lead and be within one possession at the break. The halftime adjustment that Oregon State needs to make sure they don't take a bad loss here?
Stick to your game plan. Until Maryland Eastern Shore forces you to throw the ball out the paint, keep pounding the paint. Devon Collier is shooting 60% from the field, 70% from the field on this season. Throw him the basketball. Let him make plays. Hey, it might get blocked once or twice, but make them block it 4 or 5 times before you start abandoning your game plan.
As we saw, it was Collier setting up Angus Brandt early. That seemed to be a successful formula for the Beavs. Brandt, the only player in double figures. He's got 10. We'll be back with our second half next.
This Pac-12 basketball production is brought to you in high definition by Xfinity, only from Comcast.
There's no such thing as no man's land to me. A man just needs a place where he can be wild and free. Ten Calvary.
Dr. Pepper 10, manliest low-calorie soda in the history of mankind. Bold flavor.
Oakland was deteriorating. Kids were dropping out of school. Something had to be done. I made a decision. I walked into the first grade class one morning and I told them, stay in school and I will send you to college. As of today, 136 students have benefited from the Early Brown Foundation. I needed a bank that cares about educating the community. When I make a promise, I'm going to keep it. Bank of the West helps me keep that promise.
It's college football season, and the orders are pouring in.
Sales spike, I'm happy.
Profits up, I'm happy.
Millions of fans, no time. I'm nervous.
Can we handle the logistics?
Use UPS. Digital tracking, proactive alerts, less paperwork. We save time, customers get what they need. Everybody's happy.
Hey! Buckeyes happy.
Gators happy.
Hogs happy.
I'm happy.
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 It's a win.
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 Win!
I love logistics.
What does it feel like to get a great deal at Happy Honda Days? Like this.
It's a winter wonderland, and the snow is gonna blow.
Catch the spirit with a great deal on a 2013 Civic with standard features like Bluetooth and a rear view camera from KBB.com's Best Value brand. Right now at your Honda dealer.
Here we go with the second half from Oregon State University, and it figures to be a better one than maybe we had anticipated. Thanks to the work of Hakeem Baxter, Isaac Smith, and other Hawks, they're within one of Angus Brandt and the Bees.
They're a guard-oriented team, and once those shots started falling, and those were shots, JB, that in the first few minutes of the half, they got open looks. They just missed them. And we said if they start knocking those down, this would be a different game. So Oregon State has to locate those shooters, get out to them, and have good closeouts on the perimeter.
Hawks are not a good shooting team. 39% on the season, 28% from three-point range.
And they're also not a good road team with their 22 consecutive losses on the road, but you want to tell that by their performance so far today.
Brandt with the first miss out of the break, and right away the Hawks have a chance to take the lead.
Oregon State electing to start off in a man-to-man, which is the right defense. It allows you to have a matchup responsibility and get out to every shooter.
A dozen left for Isaac Smith III. matched up with Roberto Nelson. Now five left. Gives it to Snyder. And that is a bad kick because it moves the shot clock to 15 seconds. What was left, two or three?
Yeah, usually coaches like deflections, kick balls, but not when there's 2 or 3 seconds left on the shot clock.
So the Hawks bailed out. They'll get the sideline inbound in front of their bench. Baxter took that on-ball screen, turned the corner, and he's going to put a foul on Angus Brinks.
There has to be more of a show for the guy that's defending the screener. You have to turn the ball handler back. You see, it's Victor Robbins. He steps out, but then he goes back. Charlie Barton is late. Angus Brandt is late on the rotation. Baxter started his upward motion before Brandt was able to get his feet set, which is the new point of emphasis this season.
Great shot of Brandt there, shaking his head, frustrated with himself. That's only his first personal foul. Baxter into double figures.
Well, if you're Angus Brandt, as the player, you feel like you got there in time. You know, you don't. It's only a point, few hundredths of a second that you're not there. Camera never lies. That's one thing you always do as a player. The film doesn't lie.
And Brandt got his hand on that offensive rebound, but not enough to secure it. Tied up with Ezeru. So the Hawks will get it back.
Well, there I feel like Angus allowed the play before to beat him two times. Instead of getting it out of his head, which he normally does. He's a mentally strong kid. He allowed it to affect him, didn't get the box out, and now you give the Hawks another chance. Easy inbound to the free throw line.
Snyder missed essentially a free throw. Victor Robbins had a quiet first half. He does have that rebound, and they clearly want to go to the block. They had Brandt and now Collier. Those two passing, could not score. The board looks like the Bees will keep it. Ezra will take the personal.
And here's my point, JB. That is the right play. It did not result in a made basket, but you got it down to Devon Collier. He forced some help. Angus Brandt, one dribble, you pretty much get a 2-foot shot at the basket. Although you don't make it, that's the right play to make. Force Maryland to Shore to defend that over and over again.
I said to you during our halftime, just off the air, how does Ezra only have two fouls? He's their only true post player. The Bees should be going right at him. And they just put the third on the UMES center. How about that off the back inbound pass by Robbins?
Smart play.
Eshak Pitt picks up the foul. Again, Robbins to inbound. This time, Nelson on the dribble pull-up.
That's a good shot for him.
1-9 is Nelson, quickly the other way. Smith missed. Charlie Barton with the push.
And this is what Oregon State has to do, speed the game up. This is the tempo they want to play at.
Nelson sliding inside, and he earns a trip to the line as well.
You know, for a while, Maryland Eastern Shore was winning the battle tempos. They slowed Oregon State down. They sped the game up only when they wanted to. But Oregon State now getting a couple defensive stops. They're able to get out in transition. And Roberto, you have to respect his three-point shot. That's what so good at driving the basketball. He's not necessarily the fastest guy, although he is sneaky athletic. But because you have to defend him 25 feet from the basket, he has driving angles that always open up.
Nelson a chance to cap the three-point play. Able to put the fourth foul on Ezeru, who was a shot-blocking difference maker in that first half. He's now saddled and on the Hawks bench.
Now Oregon State to that 1-3-1.
And travel will give it back. Smith with the turnover.
Well, JB, we've talked about it plenty of times. In order to beat that 1-3-1, you go four corners. That's where your four open spots are. You allow one of your players to roam around in the middle and just read what's going on. But then there's a premium on your passing and your ball handling, decision making. It's one thing to get guys in the right spots, but then you have to execute the right passes.
Collier, look at the size difference inside now with he and Brandt after they took Ezra out of the game. I mean, it's a game changer.
Yeah, and it's a percentage game when you throw to Devon Collier. If he misses one, his percentages say he's going to make the next one. He's shooting 70% from the field. You got to throw it down to the big fella. He's so crafty. He's long. He's got a quick second jump. So if he misses it, he's probably going to get it back.
Now, Collier 6'8", Brandt is 6'10". No one on the floor taller than 6'6", and that's truthfully being generous for the Hawks right now. Jones Jones and Baxter surveying this trapping zone. Whistle as Collier goes tumbling. That will be his first personal foul, so no real foul trouble to speak of for Oregon State. A little bit of breathing room now at 40-34 after is a one-point game at half.
Right now, Maryland Eastern Shore making it easy on Oregon State. Now they've got to a little bit of a four-corner setup. That's where you're going to get your shots.
Jones from the corner, off the mark, offensive board. Troy Snyder.
I told you at halftime that Oregon State was going to at some point go into this 1-3-1, and if the Hawks can figure out how to beat it, not necessarily score against it, but how to get good looks against it, they would have a chance in this game. At the end of that last possession, they finally figured it out. Those four corners is what's open.
Not a strength of Snyder's game is the free throw line, just 53% for the senior from Chicago. And he leaves both at the line. Collier secures.
And here Oregon State needs to run.